And it's basically two bells that have two different pitches. High sound and low sound. All right? So a lot of these two bells kind of form the samba. But many times these, you can also produce another sound by clicking them. So with all that, now we hold the triangle such where we can, one, see the conductor, we can see the music, and everything's right in view. A couple ways to play this is you want to usually play opposite the opening. Okay, it produces usually the best sound, or at the bottom. Okay, if we play on this side, for some reason, it doesn't sound as good. Okay? Okay, to do rolls on a triangle, okay, it is not, and I repeat, not, Ma Kettle's Kitchen. Okay? Well, get it. Okay? That's not the, okay? We go up and down, either in the corner or at the top. Now watch, listen to when I do it in the corner. Doesn't sound as good. Also, by holding it, it gives me the chance to stop the sound. All right? So, triangle. This is a larger triangle. Sometimes we use the clip with it, sometimes we don't. Okay, so if I just spin it on my hand, it still produces a pretty good sound. But not as good as the clip. Larger triangles, again, used in Brazilian music a lot of times. Obviously, we can muffle it a lot faster. We can go fast. Different things with that, by muffling it, by, you know, just going back and forth and doing rhythms with it. Okay, so that's it for triangle. This unique instrument, we use them as doorstops here at PCC, it's a brake drum. It's a brake drum to a car, okay? And I'm in good with Wendy, who teaches over an auto shop, and whenever she gets brake drums in, she gives me a call and I go up and pick in like six of them up. And they produce a great sound. Some of my friends visit junkyards regularly and find the most bizarre sounds. They go through with a mallet and start hitting junk. And, you know, I mean, there used to be suspension spring coils, and they pick up those. And brake drums. They just produce bizarre sounds. You can use them with what I call different implements. Okay, implements are like sticks or metal beaters, or I'll show you other things too. But they usually have different sounds. So we have a variety of brake drums here that we just kind of beat on and. Just produce sounds. We get a lot of percussion pieces that call for brake drums, believe it or not. Problem is, now they're doing brakes, they're disc brakes, and these are getting more scarce. So, kind of interesting there. Good. Let's get into some of the Latin percussion instruments now. These are called what? Anybody?
Bongos.
Right. Bongos. Okay. Bongos can be played several different ways. They can be played with sticks. Bongos always in pairs of two. Okay. Like I said, in sticks. Right? Yeah. Okay. They can also be played in between your legs, like so. And I have different motions to produce different sounds. Okay. So bongos. These particular drums are called congas. Okay, congas come in three different sizes, basically. Quinto is the smallest one. A conga is the middle one. And what they call a tumba is the large drum. This, I believe, is a conga, and this is a quinta. Quinta is a higher pitched drum. And a lot of different techniques on this. First technique is what we call an open tone. Okay, no dampening, no muffling at all. Another tone is what we call a dead tone. Not just simply taking your palm and placing it on the drum and keeping it there. Okay? The next sound is what we call a slap, where I'm dampening the head with one hand and grabbing it with the other. It produces this sound. Sometimes called a pop, sometimes called a slap. So with the combination of all of these different hand movements, we have the dead tone, and then we kind of open tone, dead tone, open tone. And what we do is rock our hands back and forth. So we have...
Juki just brought up, she's video recording, and the snares keep vibrating in sympathy to you.
Yes.
I was wondering if you could turn
Sorry, Ted, I don't know how to take them off.
I'll get to that in a second.
Thank you.
Yeah.
What you can...
Sorry to interrupt.
Tell how to answer. Okay, so with you can produce different sounds. Basically a conga, and it just have kind of different things. You can produce weird sounds on it, kind of like the tambourine. Kind of like a whale sound. Kind of by just rubbing your finger on the head. Question.
So question for you. This is one of the instruments, or this, the two congas is one of the instruments they're going to be writing for.
Okay.
And I wonder, too, first question is, if they don't want to worry about any special thing, can they just write a rhythm and not worry about any special technique, if they want to? You know.
Yes, and
then the next question is, if they do want to do special things, how do they indicate that to a percussionist so a percussionist knows what they're asking for?
And there are no rules here that say you have to use your hands on these. You can use sticks. You know, that's fine. They're made out of calf skin. You're not going to break them.
And I have a marker.
And kind of a
No, you can go. You can go here.
When I
join
you. Oh, you know, I don't get
such a choir, right?
Oh, I thought you were there.
What would that mean? Okay, the X's are pretty standard for us. That means muffled. And the O's are open. So that would be a typical kind of thing. If you want, you can do it a couple ways. And then obviously, The lower line is the lower pitch. Okay, so you know. And depending on how experienced, they would know to go. Sorry. Standard notation for us, X's mean muffled, opens mean open. Similar on triangle. Okay, so that's pretty standard for us. And congas you can play on the side. Play with sticks. Okay, bongos with sticks. Most of the time we use single stroke rules, and single means alternating, opposed to double stroke rules where we do. Just sounds cleaner on these drums for some reason.
One more question, Tad. You did with your hand, you with a stick. What do they need to do to tell it if they want a stick versus a hand? What would they need to write on the staff? I know it's not hard, but we need to
just put hands. Yeah. You know,
or with
hands.
Or with sticks.
With or hands or with sticks.
Yeah,
yeah.
More often than not, just be explicit. If you want something, ask for it.
Oh, yeah, exactly. And I guess this is a good time to kind of go through my variety of bag of tricks. And you know, I'm pretty equipped with anything I would ever want. Different sticks obviously produce different sounds. Standard percussionist yarn mallets, okay? Usually felt mallets, timpani sticks or something like that. Obviously drumsticks, okay? We also have hard plastic mallets, okay? And I'll get into these and show you what to do and what not to do in a second. Do I have any brushes? Brushes are pretty standard. Okay, this sounds like this. Looks like this. Opposed to. Just different implements make different sounds. These are called like lutas. They produce kind of a, you know, what kind of sound that is, but you hear the kind of sticks hitting together also. That's kind of it. I mean, we have, you know, specialty things with, you know, little brass things that are much brighter. Sharp sounding opposed to. So be explicit. If you want sticks, if you want brushes, if you want mallets, if you want timpani mallets, felt, you know, just ask for it. And they will have it.
And if someone's in doubt and they don't really know what they want, is it okay just to write a rhythm and then just trust that the percussionist will play it with the normal kind of stick or something? You know.
Depending on the instrument.
Right, of course.
Depending on the instrument. You know, most triangle will be, you know, metal beaters. You know, I get occasional where, you know, they ask for brushes, but usually you can't hear them or something like that.